This is the NP Crayon Keycap Set from KBD Fans. It's dye sublimated on PBT plastic in the NP or PG profile. It's available in several different configurations, each with a 181 key kit for $69. You can choose between pure white and milky white, and between no sublegends, hiragana, hangul, or cyrillic. I opted for the pure white with hangul sublegends. NP is a uniform height profile. This means that every key in this set is exactly the same height. In contrast, sculpted profiles like Cherry or SA feature rows of varying heights to create an ergonomic typing experience. Pretty much all of my experience with mechanical keyboard keycap sets has been with sculpted profiles, Cherry, OEM, and CAT. So I wanted to try out a uniform profile for a change. The more common uniform profiles are DSA and XDA. NP seems to be exclusive to KBD fans. Here's a great comparison from imager user Cyberbeard that really shows the differences and similarities between these three profiles. I picked these NP keycaps because they're so darn cute and I'd had my eye on them for a while. This was during my early days as an enthusiast, and I was very hesitant back then because it seemed like a lot of money for keycaps. Fast forward to the present and the monetary value hasn't changed, but I now don't see it as too much anymore. Hashtag cursed. Coming from mostly Cherry keycaps, there was an adjustment period for me. I made quite a lot of mistakes while typing at first. I think much of it can be attributed to the surface area of NP versus Cherry. The former is square, while the latter is rectangular with a height greater than its width. After a few days, I got used to it, and I'm now even going back and forth between NP and Cherry without too much issue. For max comfort, I would still choose a sculpted profile though. These aren't just uniform in height, they're also completely symmetrical on all sides. This means that there is no correct orientation for a blank 1U keycap. I learned this when I was mounting the novelty arrow keys. I thought each corresponded to a specific direction, but they all had the same centered print, so you're free to put each in any of the four positions. The PBT material on these is nice and thick, about as thick as my EPBT and Geek Arc sets. They also have a pretty noticeable, pleasant, rough texture. As for warp, strangely enough, the longer space bars are pretty straight. It's the 3U space bar that's most warped. KBD fans doesn't mention a GMK color reference for these, but the pure white seems to sit in between WS1 and WS2 in terms of color warmth. There's a strange issue with this set when paired with C3 stabilizers. It's very easy to pop the stabilized keys off the stabilizer stems. You don't have to exert that much force, and you don't have to press that far off center, and they just pop right off. This issue does not exist with Duroc screw-ins or Duroc plate mounts. The legends on this set are very nice. The font is pleasant and consistent. The lines aren't the thickest, but it looks good. The alphas are a dark gray, and they go very well with the explosion of color in the mods and the novelties. I don't see any major cases of misalignment of print either. The aesthetic is the main draw of these keycaps, and they resoundingly deliver. This kit contains 181 keys, which is a lot. It can cover almost every layout. ISO enter is really the only thing this has missing. And the beauty of a uniform profile keycap set is that you can put any key on any row. So the kit only has to provide one each of keys like the nav keys. And you can even use any of the numerous novelties wherever they can fit. And speaking of novelties, you get a whopping 44 1U novelties, including 4 arrow keys. Only 4 1.25U, which you can use as bottom row mods or a split left shift. Only 2 1.5U, also for bottom row mods or as tab and pipe. A single 1.75U as a short right shift or caps lock. A single 2U for backspace or 2U shift. And a single 2.25U for enter or full left shift. As extensive as this novelty selection may seem, you can't actually fill your mods with all novelties, since they're mostly just 1U. I know, because I try. I kind of wish they'd turn some of the 1U novelties into some bigger ones. Oh well, less is more, I guess. In terms of sound, there's not much to say. They sound like a thick PBT keycap set, but you can listen for yourself to the sound tests at the end of this video. This is a very high quality in-stock set with an adorable head-turning design. I honestly can't think of any negatives for it. I guess the price? At $69, it's not cheap, but you do get what you pay for. Great build quality, design, legending, and a massive kit. And it's not even as expensive as an EPBT die subset or of course, something from GMK. Depending on your preference, the profile might be a negative, but I found it wasn't that hard to adapt to and does actually have some advantages as I talked about. The NP PBT Crayon keycap set gets an emphatic recommendation from me. What did you think? Do you like the look of this keycap set as much as I do? If you own this set, please let us know in the comments about your experience with it. We're going to end with some sound tests in a couple of different configurations, and also back-to-back with the Cherry profile set for comparison. If you'd like to support my journey to monetization, please stay until the end. And if you found this video helpful, informative, entertaining, or any other positive adjective, please consider giving it a like and subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. Thank you so much for watching.